If only we could fly.
Limp Bizkit style. How can Limp Bizkit fans come expect for Soundwave this year? Something you really want
to... You know, we always kind of... we don't really plan too much. And we usually make the set list like 10 minutes before we go on. And we'll just put a bunch of songs on a piece of paper, and sometimes we'll skip through, sometimes it just depends on the crowd and what they're feeling, and yeah, we just kind of like improvise. Sometimes we even like the crowd decide what song we want to do.
So you will change the set list?
We're not stuck to a computer with a set, you know, like we can only... can't like switch it around, you know? So yeah, we can just do whatever we want, you know? A digital generation.
Band or any rock musician that you want to see or meet in some way?
Oh yeah, I want to see System. That's really bad. I mean, I love Slipknot. We just played with them a few times, and they're awesome. But yeah, I'm looking forward to seeing Hole.
Oh,
she's not coming?
No, I'll spread for that.
actually, I don't think anybody cares anyway.
No, nobody cares.
I'm just kidding. No, and I want to see System. I haven't seen them in a while. We've toured together a long time ago, doing like family values and stuff. So, and they're good friends. They're like the drummer Ron and stuff. And I'm excited to see them.
Cool.
I mean, I'm excited overall. It's just, it's a good lineup. You know what I mean? There's a lot of good bands.
What is this feeling, this anxiety, that coming back to Australia after like, I think it's 15 years ago?
I think it was about 10.
On the last video, with all what's happened at that time. So how is it feeling coming back?
It feels good to come back, you know. It's a sore subject, but, you know, I think overall it's led to change in the way that promoters and concert companies do their barricades and provide the security and change it now so it's safer, you know. There's no way, we didn't go intentionally and hope somebody or plan that somebody's gonna, you know, something's gonna happen and get hurt at a concert, you know. So I think overall, you know, you can't like replace or, you know, a life, you know, it's very sad. And it's, you know, it's a dark cloud that hovers over us, but it feels good to come back, and the people are accepting to come back, and they understand, and from what I understand, people here, they're not blaming Limp Bizkit for that. They have a dedication every big day out now to the girl, and, it's more like big day out kind of took responsibility and knew that they should have had their barricades, you know. And we made a big deal before we went on about the way the barricades were, and they said, you know, all the barricades were great, and then, you know.
Last night,
how was the
experience?
How was
like the chair, the stage, the place with so many talents, like Mark
Thurum
or an Australian talent like
Lamb or something
like that?
Yeah, I played outside. There was a VIP party up here, so it's a general population people that weren't on the guest list couldn't get in, and I already like told everybody to come outside, it's free, come say hi, everything. So, you know, I felt like if I play up here, they wanted to bring me up here, and I was like, well, I already told people to come see me, and I don't care if there's five people that came to see me. If they came to see me, and I can't get them in, then I don't want to play upstairs. I want to play down here for those five people. You know, I've invited fans and people to come see me, so. But it was awesome. There was a couple of bands that really liked the Screaming Bikinis.
Yeah.
They're badass.
Every kid grows up with a boogeyman under his bed. Mine terrorized Greenwich Village and smoked Newports.
Charlie Banks never knew what his life was supposed to be.
Oh, thanks. These were a gift.
I remember being a freshman. It was the two best years of my life.
What do you think about Fred Duff's filmmaking career? Is
satisfying to do something? I think it's great. He has a network. He's been directing videos and stuff. He's directed all our videos. He's directed videos for like porn and, you know, different artists. So he has a great eye for it, and I think it's great. I think it's cool. You know, it's like everybody should have other things they would like to do. You can't just do one thing all the time. You know, you gotta do different things and have different hobbies and stuff. And, he's having fun doing it, and I'm happy for him, you know? I wish him luck.
Oh yeah, what is next for you? We saw online that you were doing the charity things too. What is next for you?
Right now I'm working on another La Coca Nostra record, which is my other band with the guys from House of Pain. And it's a hip-hop project. We put a record out in 2008 and did a tour all around. And so we're making a new record with that. Then we're probably going to make a new House of Pain record. And then I have a new group called Party Slayers with a Z, which is more like my electronic side, you know, kind of like Wolfgang Gartner, Dead Mouse, little bit of Skrillex, sounding hard, you know, just crazy, electronic stuff, you know. Like, I'm a gear freak, and I love drum machines, and I have so many synthesizers, so I like to, you know, just be creative and different, so, and I'm producing a lot, and then bringing up some artists, and there's a lot of stuff. Actually, I'm not doing shit. I'm just lying to you. I just hang out. I'm just planning to just hang out on my couch for the next year and watch Beatles and play games. Yeah, that's the way I'm looking at it. You know, some people are saying, oh, they got dropped because the record sold 63,000. Like, what? It's like, we didn't get dropped. We got off of there, and we're lucky to get off of there because our contract is like so old that they don't have us. They didn't own all of us. Like, now new bands they sign, they like sign their life away. Like, they're a piece of their merchandising, these are the concerts, publishing, everything, you know, so they didn't own all of us, so, and we were doing fine just touring without a record, you know, before Bill Cobra even came out, we were headlining festivals in Europe and all that stuff, so, yeah, I see it as a fresh start. We already have offers from labels, and, you know, we'll see, we might just keep it independent. The distribution deal, and you know, I see it as a fresh start. They weren't, Chris Gilbert isn't doing anything for us. They're just worried about Lady Gaga and selling headphones.
What advice would you give to all the Australian musicians who wants to follow your steps?
I just say be original and just follow your dreams. Set some goals and just follow your dreams. And just every day try to accomplish a little bit closer to your dream. And fate and destiny has a lot to play with it. Don't get too discouraged if like your first stuff isn't like, successful. Just follow your dream.
About my future generation, we don't